need to heat the bag up on put on the heating plate at 80 degrees for 15 minutes. So the glue on the nail, and we can open the bag and without breaking the glass. The back glass, if the bag not break. After we heat them for 15 minutes, use a razor to put at the corner. Try to lift up a little bit. Try to lift up careful so we could not want to break the glass. Okay, make it big enough until we can put a plastic, a piece of plastic, hot plastic in to go all around. Okay. Now we can go all around of the bag. It could be very easy if after we heat them. And then we can go, you know, like not too deep at first. Make sure all the glue around break. And then we can go deeper. Put this plastic in deeper to break the glue in the middle. We need to damage anything. Okay. Now the back. Now the back is open. Now we use the Phillips screwdriver to open all the screws of the bag. Look like they have a lot of screws. Now we take off all the screws at the bottom. Remember, take off the S-pen and then the seam tray on the top so we can take off the frame. You can push the spot right here, hold the frame on the top and open it. But don't force too much. Okay. Now the frame is open. So after the frame is take off, you can change the battery or the carrier or the earpiece, whatever you like. The flag on the ball, so we can take off the motherboard out and change the LCD. The flag right here, this flag, this flag, LCD flag. Use the tweezer to take off this dual tender. Okay, now we can lift the motherboard up, and the charging port connect to the motherboard, so we can lift up a little bit and take off. LCD. Okay, after we take the motherboard out, we're gonna put on the heating plate for 15 minutes. I'm gonna put on the heating plate machine at 80 degrees for 15 minutes before I can take off the LCD and change the new one. after we put the screen on the heating machine, we need we use the heat gun to heat up on the bottom a little bit because the home flex sensor is under the screen. So we heat a little bit more so it can open easier and without breaking the home flex sensor. Open the broken screen and change the new one. Nice, you get the little pry to open. Because they have a lot of glue inside, so we need to do this. Careful now with the glue down on the bottom. Make the whole flat. Take a little longer at this part right here. And now on this bottom, so we're not going to break the flag. This part we need to be patient. To break all the glue. I'm gonna make another video just to change the charging port for the Note 5 without breaking the LCD. Because this LCD broke anyway, that's why I just care about this flag. And now we take it out without damage. That bad LCD, the broke LCD had separate from the fan. It's a new LCD for the Note 5. When you change, you need to put the tape on the bottom and on the top of the screen. I use the red tape with the two sides, the thin one. To go around like this, to go around right here on the top and on the bottom. Put some tape on the bottom and on the top of the screen. Maybe we don't need on the side. So we put the new LCD in on the frame. Make sure we clean the frame. Make sure we clean everything, glue and glass or anything of the frame. All this adhesive need to come out. because you want any tool that easier and faster for you to take off this car adhesive. It only got heat, so it's kind of soft. Make sure the LCD flex, they are light dry at the position. Okay, now we peel off this cover, blue cover adhesive. This flag in also, we make sure this earpiece mesh gonna fit this, and then to the bottom the home button gonna fit. This means you wanna put in right. Okay, then we gently press the screen down of the frame. So let's to make it stick to the tip that we previously put on. Now we start with the motherboard back on the frame. Now we put the ball back to the frame and use the tweezer to take up all this flag up. All this flag have to be on the ball. Make sure the charging port in place. Okay, so we can snap the ball down. this last one. Let's see if we're missing any flag that not snapped on. Fit the camera first and then we press down the rest.